Institute of Human Behaviour and Allied Sciences, IHBAS, IBAS as it acronyms, is a hospital-based academic institution in the fields of mental health, neurosciences, and behavioral sciences. What IBAS does as a hospital is essentially offers three medical clinical specialties: psychiatry, neurology, neurosurgery, and two associated non-medical clinical disciplines of clinical psychology and psychiatric social work. We have a whole lot of other allied disciplines, from laboratories to radiology and imaging to academic disciplines like epidemiology and biostats and so forth. When the old mental hospital became IBAS 21 years ago, the predominant parameter was number of inpatients, or inmates as they were called. What IBAS has been able to demonstrate is the paradigm shift that has occurred in mental health and neuroscience care that has shifted the focus from inpatient care to outpatient care. Arguably, this is the largest psychiatry outpatient in the world. We see about 900 psychiatry patient visits every day, 6 days a week. That 900 figure includes 100 new cases registered every day and 800 follow-up visits.
From the beginning, we ensure that most of our clients actually are treated from the outpatient. If we see the stats, less than 1% get actually admitted in the hospital. And from there as well, we ensure that there is a pre-admission counseling done by social worker. Also, we ensure that most of the patients have an average length of stay of about 3 to 4 weeks. And we have an active psychiatric social work department who ensures that the rehabilitation of the patients back in the community is ensured following the acute treatment. And we liaison with the community outreach clinics so that these patients can follow up after the discharge from the clinics.
99% of the people can be and are being treated effectively on OPD basis, being with their families, continuing with their lives. All the destitute, homeless, mentally ill that we get through police and magistracy or our own initiatives and the NGOs that we work with generally are a very difficult group of persons to rehabilitate or reintegrate back into the society. We had about 15 years ago 44 such long stay persons, we now have 45. There is no point only deinstitutionalizing after the congestion has occurred. But the trick, it seems to me, is in not letting the congestion happen. In academic theoretical terms, one would go beyond deinstitutionalization to term this as prevention of institutionalization. For about 15 years, we as a public-funded hospital have actually gone out to the street on our own and worked with NGOs and community-based organizations to offer mental health and drug abuse services as part of the outreach on the street.
Mobile mental health services are a unique, innovative services sponsored by the state, which essentially cover pre-hospital care and partly post-hospital care. The services are rendered by a multidisciplinary team, which consists of a medical officer, counselor, nursing staff, a nursing orderly, and a mobile van. This is an essential service to cater to underprivileged population, which is primarily homeless population, and in homebound situations where families are in the distress and they give us a call.
IHBAS believes in communitization of the patient care, and it has been also enshrined in our mission statement of the institute. We are currently providing the community outreach services in 5 centers across the state. They provide the clinical services, they have liaison with the NGOs working in the area, and they also do the training program for the medical as well as paramedical professionals of that district. We ensure that this is provided as per the National Mental Health Program.
We have the magistracy and the judiciary joining in. You would see an NGO worker, the hospital psychiatrist, and a magistrate on the pavement on any Monday or Thursday evening in the inner city of Delhi.
The marginalized population, they have a different need, and their access to the care is very, very poor. So bridge the treatment gap for such population, we have to have such kind of community-based outreach initiative, which provides treatment on the street, which is acceptable to those communities.
The homeless people in the city, they come here. On these 2 days, Monday and Thursday, they would get free of cost medicine, get diagnosed, and they will get the best treatment from best doctors of IHBAS and a general physician who is a volunteer.
People hesitate coming to us when problems are mild, and only because of stigma and negative meaning which is attached to. So if that is handled and managed, then people can come at very early stage without any difficulty, hesitation or anything. And that can definitely make our position much better.
The Indian affiliate of the JCI, the Joint Councils International, is called the National Accreditation Board for Hospitals and Healthcare Organizations, NABH. IHBAS is one of the very few public-funded organizations in any specialty and one of the rare public or private sector mental health organization that is actually accredited for quality, patient safety and quality of care. The Institute of Human Behaviour and Allied Sciences, IHBAS, Delhi, would not want to rest on laurels of last two decades, but would want to look forward in terms of maintaining the excellence and quality, furthering the community outreach, making better research impact, and actually being one of the world-class centers in mental health and neurosciences.
देखिएगा हमारी सरकार ने सोचा है कि अभी तक जो ध्यान था ना सारा का सारा डिजीज़ के ऊपर था अब इसको हम चेंज करना चाहते हैं 80% डिजीज़ के ऊपर ध्यान देंगे तो साथ साथ 20% हेल्थ के ऊपर भी देंगे ठीक है IHBAS जो है ना हिंदुस्तान के अंदर बहुत बड़ी एक संस्था है इंडिया के टॉप टू जो हमारे संस्थान हैं उनमें से एक है इसको हम अब आगे बढ़ाना चाहते हैं अभी जैसे एक कैंपस के अंदर काम कर रहे हैं उससे काम करने से काम नहीं चलेगा कम से कम पूरी दिल्ली के अंदर ये फैल जाए तो हम इस चीज़ को काफ़ी बड़े स्केल पे ले जाना चाहते हैं और इसका बहुत फ़ायदा उठाएंगे और हमारे पास लकीली दिल्ली के अंदर एक ऐसा इंस्टीट्यूट है कि जिसके अंदर वर्ल्ड क्लास डॉक्टर्स हैं